Hello friends, welcome back. I'm Jules. Today we're diving into my favorite apps and tools on my Mac for healthy productivity. Healthy productivity to me is acknowledging that self-care is productive. It's all about ditching that all or nothing mindset. We don't always need to be on and working and checking things off our to-do list. I talk about all these tools and tips and tricks because I want us to find more ease, more rest, and just be able to slow down. These are apps that have helped me be way more focused, productive, creative, and have just brought a lot more ease into my life, so I wanna share them with you today. Before we dive in, let's talk about my setup. I have the new M1 Mac Studio, which is my desktop computer. I decided to forgo my MacBook Pro laptop and just use my iPad instead. So when I go to coffee shops, I bring my iPad, but I do most of my heavy lifting work here at my desk on my desktop computer. It's a really powerful machine that's really good for video editing, so I've been so happy with it. My Mac Studio is 32 gigabytes, which is plenty for me. I know you can upgrade to 64 and so on, but 32 works great for my workflow. And I opted for 1 terabyte of storage. I have my Mac Studio hooked into my Samsung M8 monitor. To catch you up to speed, I decided to cancel my order for the Apple Studio display monitor and go for the Samsung M8 instead. I just couldn't justify paying so much more for the Apple display monitor for the specs that I needed, and the M8 really had everything that I was looking for. And ultimately, I was drawn to the Apple display because of the look and aesthetic of it. So when the Samsung M8 came out, I was like, oh, they look really similar and the specs are great for what I need. So why spend an extra $1,300? I could just get 2 monitors at that point. My Samsung M8 is sitting on top of this Superjair riser. That's the name of it, Superjair. I got it off of Amazon. It was like 40 bucks. I love it. It does the job. I've got my Logitech keyboard and mouse setup. This is the K380 minimalist keyboard and then the Lift vertical ergonomic mouse. And I love these two together. The pink colors are so fun. All right, enough about my setup. Let's dive into the apps. First up, I'm gonna talk about my favorite email app. It's called Spark. I've been using it for probably 5 years now. I've tested so many email apps, you guys. It's definitely a favorite pastime of mine where I will download any new email app that I think looks or sounds interesting, and I will download it and I will try it because I am always on a mission to find a better way to manage emails, because email is one of the hardest things to manage. And I think I have a pretty good system in place. It's definitely a lot better than it was in the past. I've set up the hotkeys, the shortcut. I batch when I'm gonna respond to emails. I have an autoresponder. I put all the different systems in place, but it's still one of those things that just never stops. It just never stops, and it's hard to keep up. If you're managing different email accounts or you have different team members that you want to collaborate with on emails, it's a great tool for that. You can sort it by smart or classic. Classic is chronological order. Smart groups it by people, notifications, and pinned emails. You can customize all of these different categories, and you can also share conversations with your team. This is actually my assistant Jazz, who's managing our team inbox, and she'll ask me questions about different emails and will share it with me, and we can just kind of chat in this box here. And sometimes she'll share a draft with me and we can collaborate on writing this draft. I think Spark really excels in team collaboration. You can customize different shortcuts, which is my favorite thing. So I have a custom set and I went in here and created shortcuts that made sense to me. So if I want to archive an email, I just quickly hit R. So it makes getting through my inbox a lot faster. I'm on the free plan. I've always been on the free plan. That works well for me. When it comes to privacy and data, that's something I really try to look into, and Spark specifically, because it's free, I wondered like, oh, do they sell my data? Is that how they're making money? But no, they never sell user data. They make money by having their premium tier offerings. On the topic of privacy, let's talk about my next favorite app, which is called Leave Me Alone. And it does exactly what it says it's going to do. You can easily unsubscribe from emails, and it truly unsubscribes you. It doesn't filter it to some hidden folder in your inbox. It unsubscribes you so you don't get that email from them again. Leave Me Alone, it's a paid app, you pay for it. But I would much rather pay for this because they're not profiting off of your data. There's other unsubscribers out there that are free, but they're in the business to unsubscribe you while also collecting your data and selling it. It's $9 a month. I am on the casual emailer plan. That seems to be enough, and I've already noticed a huge difference in my inbox. So if you feel like you're drowning in emails and you're on these email lists that you're like, why am I on? I never signed up for this. You can quickly go through and just hit unsubscribe. And then if you want something to be added to your roll up, you can just click add to roll up or keep it in your inbox. Besides the unsubscribing, what I think is awesome is this inbox shield. You can approach it two ways. You can either screen your entire inbox and start from scratch and only selectively allow in who you want through that screen, and then they'll block the emails that you don't want. Or you can set it to allow all new emails and it'll only block the mail that matches your active block list. Anyways, definitely check it out, dive in, see if it's worth it. It's definitely saved me time in my inbox and I feel a lot less overwhelmed. So I talked about decluttering my inbox, but let's talk about decluttering computer files. Clean My Mac is absolutely clutch for clearing out my computer clunk, junk, computer junk. I typically do this once a month. I'll go through and I'll scan my computer. It'll clean up unneeded files. It'll check how protected my computer is. It'll check the speed. It clears out the unneeded junk. It cleans up mail attachments, systems junk, frees up your RAM. And besides the fact that Clean My Mac keeps my computer tidy and frees up space, it's just the little things that makes it stand out. The UI is really nice. The little bells and the sounds are really pleasant. So I enjoy running this. If you like to download a lot of apps like me, uninstaller comes in handy. So on the topic of installing apps, I am a serial app installer. So if you like to download and try out lots of different apps like me, you're gonna love this tool. It is called setapp. Setapp comes from the same creators as Clean My Mac as well as Gemini. It's the app that I use to declutter my camera roll. I'll leave that video link down below. And the makers of this app are from a company called macpaw. Basically, the macpaw team makes world-class apps. They're based in Ukraine, and I'm very excited to be working with them today officially to share with you some of my favorite apps from them. They're in the business to solve your problems, and setapp essentially does that. It is a productivity toolkit. It's a curation of some of the best apps out there, and you just pay one monthly subscription and you can download all the different apps that you want. So for me, as someone who has paid individually for apps, setapp has been amazing. I can also search by the task I'm trying to complete or the problem I'm trying to solve. So if I'm trying to organize my files, I can search organize files and it'll show me all these different apps that they have curated, that they stand behind, that they would recommend for me to download and manage my different files. Another thing that's really cool is I can search different collections. You can see setapp's starter kit. These are apps that they recommend you get started with, and I can download all of them without paying for each individual app, which I think is brilliant. I have Clean My Mac, obviously. I've also got Clean Shot, which is something that I found through setapp, and it's what I'm using right now to screen record this video. You can search all the different categories of apps from lifestyle to creativity, productivity. If you're writing and blogging, they're always updating the apps, adding new things, and you can easily uninstall it if you don't want it anymore. Thank you to setapp for partnering with me and for creating such incredible tools that I use in my daily life. All right, so some of those apps you may or may not have heard before, but this next one I'm pretty sure you've heard we talk about at length, and it is Notion. For me, Notion is by far the number one holy grail productivity app ever. It has changed my life. It has changed my business. Everything that I care about is in my Notion. I have videos and videos about Notion and how I use it, so I won't go into depth in this video, but I will show you that I use it for my personal life. I have my life hub. I use Notion to plan my week, plan my year, plan my content, my partnerships. I collaborate with my team. It is my everything, and I do plan on coming out with some new resources in the future, so stay tuned for that. If you've been curious about Notion and you have not yet tried it, I definitely recommend giving it a shot because it is one of those apps that didn't click for me right away. And it took me a few months before I was finally like, all right, let me put some time into this and figure out if this is an app for me. Notion is an incredible tool for helping create focus while also making it beautiful and aesthetic and something that you enjoy looking at every single day. That is the perfect little segue into Google Calendar. You all know how much I love and use my Google Calendar. I've talked about it at length with customizing it and hotkeys and different ways that I use Google Calendar to get my daily tasks done. I integrate Google Calendar with my Notion workflow, and I have a video all about that linked down below. I use the app on my phone. I use it on my computer. Where would I be without Google Calendar? I don't know. Honestly, if something is not in my calendar, it is not in my brain. I use Google Calendar to keep me on track to the goals that I set and the tasks that I say that I'm gonna do. I very heavily use the task feature on Google Calendar. So you click task. So I might write something like film YouTube video. And I would say, okay, Friday the 13th at 11 a.m., I'm filming that YouTube video. After that, I'm going to catch up on emails. And it helps me stay on track for my day and it holds me accountable to getting things done. Beyond having this more robust, dynamic to-do list in Notion, Google Calendar is taking that a step further and actually tracking when you're gonna do that and helping to plan your most ideal week. And I love it more than a physical planner because things change. You have to stay fluid and flexible so you can easily change it, but things don't get lost in the shuffle and they always stay front of mind. I use Google Calendar on my phone and it looks a little something like this. The colors that I changed on my desktop do match my colors on my phone. Some of you have written me that you've had trouble getting the colors to sync, but I think it's as simple as turning on or off a setting. I'm not sure. Mine is working that way. And so I love the Google Calendar app. I have a little widget on my home screen so I can see what my day is looking like. And I think their functionality is only getting better and better. The next app I want to talk about is Slack. It is how I communicate and collaborate with my team. So I have 5 people on my team that I work with that I talk to almost every day. Slack is the best way for us to manage our communication and just cut back on the emails and the back and forth. It's just more of like a chat. So we have different channels where we can talk about specific things. You can direct message people. But what I really love about Slack is how I can voice memo people. You can hop on video calls, voice huddles. I honestly don't think I'd be able to function as well as I do without Slack. The next app I want to talk about is Milanote. This is the app that I use for my creative projects, for things like designing my house or rebranding home bodies, which we're actively working on. It's the app that I use to take all those creative ideas and those brainstorms and throw it into a place that I can drag, drop, organize, create mood boards out of. It really follows the intuitive flow of how ideas are made and the creative process. So I love being able to take those conceptual ideas and turn them into concrete plans. And then at that point, I'd probably organize the project management steps in my Notion. The last app that I use every single week is Canva. In Canva, anyone can create something that they are proud of, that is on brand for them. They make it so easy. I use Canva every single week for designing pins, for designing thumbnails, creating freebies, creating opt-ins, updating my media kit. You don't have to be a designer, but you can create your own visual identity using their templates, adding in your own colors, your own brand fonts and assets. Truly, I've ditched Photoshop. Photoshop who? I'm continuously impressed by Canva and their functionality, even being able to remove the background of images. I used to do that in Photoshop and it would take me forever using the lasso tool to cut myself out. And here I just hit one button and boom, that's pretty good. So that's Canva. Well, that, my friends, are all the apps I'm going to share with you today. There's plenty more that I could talk about and I'm always finding new fun apps that I want to share with you all. So if you enjoyed this video and you would like me to make a part 2, let me know in the comments. I love nerding out on these topics and sharing things that have made my work and personal life more streamlined, more efficient. I strongly believe in letting technology work for you. There's so many cool things out there that can bring more ease into your day. Ultimately, when you simplify and reduce clutter, you make space for the things that bring you more joy. That's all I've got for you today. Thank you for watching today's video, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye, friends.